So with that, it begs the question, does this model that we developed for the treatment of those conditions that were infectious get applied successfully over to these other now dominant diseases that are much more complex in their origin? Well, we tried to apply those models, right? So it was the pill for the ill model. So we developed pills for heart disease, and we developed pills for diabetes, and we developed pills for cancer, and we developed pills for dementia, and we developed pills for arthritis. And then we asked the question, did we actually treat any of those diseases successfully with those pills? Or did we just remediate some of the symptoms? And if we're really serious about looking at this without bias, you have to come to the conclusion the data doesn't say that we successfully treated any of those diseases at the cause. We did influence their effects. But if you look at long-term outcome studies, did we actually improve the person's and reduce their risk to death? The answer is probably no in most cases. So this model that we developed out of antibiotic therapy for infectious disease doesn't appear to be that applicable, unfortunately, to that of the treatment of these chronic illnesses. So then what do we do? we're confronted with a conundrum. And that is the moment of opportunity to say, now hold it, maybe we should go back and look at this sanitation and hygiene model, which is environment and lifestyle related, and ask, could we then modify that in the 20th century to become a 21st way of approaching, 21st century way of approaching these chronic illnesses? So then, lo and behold, another major paradigm shift occurs. It's perfect timing. And it happens almost 100 years after the recognition of microbes causing disease. And what is that? It's the deciphering of the human genome. The Rose Garden Book of Life type of disclosure in 2000 with President Clinton and the two representatives, one from the government, one from a private company, that are all collaborating to say that they have deciphered the human genome. Now, in and of itself, the deciphering of the human genome is not the answer to the question, but it is a absolute step forward in recognizing that within our genes are uniquenesses that give rise to how individuals respond to their environment.